Hello everyone, this is Shivprem, a legal intern Lexis & Company and currently pursuing BLLB honors from Central University of South Bihar. And in the today's session, I will be discussing about the types of parliamentary control. It is the second video part of the parliamentary control of delegated legislation. So, in the types, there are basically four types which I have described you before, and in the brief, I will be describing here in this video. The first one is direct general control, but general control over delegated legislation is exercised under this through the debate on the act which contains delegation. Members may discuss anything about the delegation including necessity, extent, type of delegation and the authority to which the power is delegated. Through questions and notices, any members can ask questions on any aspect of delegation of legislative power, and if dissatisfied can give notice for the discussion under rule 59 of the procedure and conduct of business in Lok Sabha rules. And through moving resolutions and notices in the house, any member may move a resolution on motion if the matter regarding delegation of power is urgent and immediate and the reply of the government is unsatisfactory. And in the second part, that is direct special control, it is the second type of the parliamentary control. This control mechanism is exercised through the technique of laying on the table of the house house rules and regulations framed by the administrative authority. The notable use of this technique was made in the Reorganization Acts of 1939 to 1969, which authorized the President to recognize the executive government by administrative rulemaking in England. The technique of laying is very extensively used because all the administrative rulemaking is the subject to the provision of Parliament under the Statutory Instruments Act 1946. Which prescribes the timetables. The most common form of provisions provides that the delegated legislation comes into an immediate effect but is subject to announcement by an adverse resolution of either house. By section 4 of the Statutory Instruments Act 1946, where subordinate legislation is required to be laid before Parliament after being made, a copy shall be laid before each house before the legislation come into operation. However, if it is essential that it should come into operation before the copies are laid, it may operate, but notification shall be sent to the Lord Chancellor and the Speaker of the House of the Commons explaining why the copies were not laid beforehand. Under section 6 of the Statutory Instruments Act 1946, the draft of any statutory instrument should be laid before the Parliament. And the third control of Parliament was parliamentary control was laying on table. In almost all the Commonwealth countries, the procedure of laying on the table of the legislature is followed. It serves two purposes. Firstly, it helps in informing the legislature as to what all rules have been made by the executive authorities in exercise of delegated legislation. And secondly, it provides a forum to legislators to question or challenge the rules made or proposed to be made. That's all in the laying out table. And in the fourth part, that is indirect control. Indirect control is exercised by Parliament through its committees with a view to strengthen parliamentary control over the delegated legislation. Scrutiny committees were established in the UK and India. There are the standing committees of Parliament to scrutinize committees. The responsibility being diffused, the responsibility is shared, but a host of committees, standing committees in each house of Congress, committees and on government operations in each house, and some other joint bodies like the Common Committee on Atomic Energy in England, The select committee and statutory instruments was established by the House of Commons in 1944. In 1950, the Law Minister made a suggestions for the establishment of the committee of each house of the pattern of the select committee on statutory instruments 1944 to examine the delegated legislation and bring to notice of the house whether administrative rule making has exceeded the intention of parliament or has departed from it or has affected any fundamental principle. So the delegated legislation as a concept is a very vital in terms of getting desired results of public welfare. Legislature, due to the burden of so much extraneous task in hand, is actually entrusting the executive. The role of committees of the parliament are important to strengthen this very exercise, and uniform rules of laying must be adhered to. Besides this, other measures should be taken to strengthen the control of parliament over the delegated legislation. Hence, every inconsistency regarding the delegation of power by legislature to the executive should be improved upon. The efficiency of such practices should be maintained. So that's all for this video, and please do like, subscribe the channel. Thank you.